Great-hand polynomials, where do we even start with something like this? Okay, notice we have z to the first power. So whenever we're trying to solve a polynomial equation that has like degree 2 or more, this is a fourth degree, we would like to make one side equal to 0 first. That said, let's bring these two terms to the other side. So we will get 2z to the fourth power minus 3z third power plus 2z squared. Bring this to the other side, we have minus 6z, and then bring that to here, minus 4, and that's equal to 0. And because you told me z is equal to 2, it's a root, so I'll just write that down for you. So note, z equals 2 is a root. So how do we get that though? Here's the hint. We can use the so-called rational zero theorem, meaning you first look at the constant term right here, which is negative 4, right? And you just look for all its factors. The factors of negative 4, or 4, is just plus or minus 1. You do both plus or minus. And then 2 also goes into 4, right? So plus minus 2. And then 4 goes into 4 as well. So we have total 6 possibilities. But not yet. We also have to look at the factors of this coefficient, which is 2. So we will have 1 goes into 2, but plus or minus. And then 2 goes into 2, like that. And what you are going to do is, you are going to divide. So for example, you do 1 divided by 1. 1 could be a root. And 2 divided by 1, 2 could be a root. 4 divided by 1, 4 can be a root. Or you can also do 1 divided by 2. So 1 half could be a root, or 1 divided by negative 2. Negative 1 half could be a root. And then you just plug in and check. And because you told me that z equals 2 is a root, I'll just verify this real quick with you guys. This means we plug in 2 into all the z's, we should end up with 0. So check this out. Well, let's see. 2 to the 4th power is 16. Times 2 is 32. 2 to the 3rd power is 8. Times 3 is 24. And then here we subtract. 2 to the 2nd is 4. Times 2 is 8. And then we add. 6 times 2 is 12, and then we subtract, and then lastly the minus 4. And let's see. This and that we get 8, and this and that we get 16. 16 minus 12 is 4, and 4 minus 4, we do end up with 0. So 2 is indeed a root. So are we done though, because we have the answer for this? No. Here's the deal. Notice we have z to the 4th power. So that means you can expect to have 4 solutions up to multiplicity, meaning sometimes a number can be repeated. And I will show you guys that later if that's the situation. Once we know z equals 2 is the root, this means we will have a factor z minus 2. I just bring the 2 to the other side, and that's the factor. That means this polynomial can be factored as z minus 2, which is a first degree polynomial, times a cubic polynomial, but I don't know what it is yet. To figure this out, we can do polynomial long division, or we can do synthetic division. Synthetic division is easier in this kind of situation, so let me show you. So first, I will draw a box like this, and then I'm going to write down the coefficients. So first, I have 2. Just write that down and pay attention to the z to the whatever power. You have to make sure that they are in order and they are over there. Right here, we have negative 3 z to the third power, so I'll put down the coefficient here is negative 3. You don't have to put a comma or anything. Just make sure you have a good enough space to make it clear. But here's the deal. If we didn't have z to the third power term, then you will have to put down a 0 here as a placeholder. Alright, for more examples like this, you can check out my other videos in the description. Anyway, here, z to the second power, so it's in order, and then the coefficient is 2. Z to the first, good, so that's negative 6. Lastly, minus 4, like this. Yeah? And then, on the outside here, what you want to put is the 2 right here. Well, another way to look at it is, if you see z minus 2, right, you have the negative 2 here, but you do the opposite, right? So if you see the negative 2, you actually put down positive 2 right there. This is a setup, and this is how it works. First, you bring down this number here. Second, you are going to take this number, multiply with that, 2 times 2 is 4, and then you are going to put down the result here. Third, you are going to add them up. For synthetic division, you add. Negative 3 plus 4 is positive 1, just like that. And then you just repeat. Take this number 2 times 1, which is 2, and you put down the result here. And then you add 2 plus 2 is 4. And then you continue. 2 times 4 is 8, put it here. Negative 6 plus 8 is 2. Lastly, this times this is positive 4. Negative 4 plus 4 is 0. The last number here is the remainder. And if you know this polynomial has this as a factor, aka like another word, z minus 2 is the root, then the remainder should always be 0. And this right here will give you the coefficient of the polynomial inside. And remember, originally it was xz. It was z to the fourth power. Here, it becomes the cubic because you divide it by z to the first. So the power goes down by 1. So this is 2z to the third power. And then this is 1z squared. And this is 4z to the first power. And this is no z, just a constant term, which we have 2z third power plus z squared, and then plus 4z, and then plus 2, like that. Okay, and then now what? You might be wondering, are we going to do the rational zero theorem again? No, you don't have to, because in fact this is factorable by grouping. We have four terms. Try to see if we can do it by grouping, and in this case, yes, we could. So check this out. I'm going to write down the z minus 2 all the way in the front, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to just group the first two terms and then group the next two terms. From these two terms, can we factor anything? Yes, z squared. So let me put up big parentheses. Let's factor out z squared like that. Okay? If we factor out z squared, then 2z to the third power will become just 2z to the first power. And then I factor out the z squared. Yeah? So that will be plus 1 like this. And of course, you can do a quick check. This times this, this times that, we do get this back. Good. Then you want to write down the sign right here. Just copy that down right away. You add. So we're going to factor out a positive number. 4z plus 2. We can factor out 2. Factor it on the outside, we get this. And then guess what? We have 2z plus 1. Aha! Very nice, isn't it? That's equal to 0. So if you just focus on the inside now, this and that are the same. So we can factor that out. So we have 2z plus 1. And then we have the remainder, right? The remaining parts, not the remainder. We have the leftovers, whatever. This and that, we can say that's z squared plus 2. Z squared plus 2. And of course, don't forget our z minus 2 all the way in the beginning. And that will give us 0. So now we have three situations to consider, right? So the first situation is z minus 2 equal to 0. Add the 2 on both sides, we know z equals 2. First answer. Secondly, we look at this. 2z plus 1 equal to 0. Put the 1 to the other side. That means 2z equals negative 1. Divide the 2 on both sides, z equals negative 1 half. That's the second answer. So in fact, we have two rational zeros. So earlier, if you did put down negative 1 half into the original, you also end up with 0. But usually, nobody likes to try with fractions. So yeah. Lastly, we have the blue one. We have z squared plus 2 equal to 0. To solve this, bring the 2 to the other side, we get z squared equals negative 2. Yeah? And then right here, this is a squared, so we are going to take the square roots on both sides, so that this and that can cancel, and on the right-hand side here, just put on plus or minus. So we will get z equals, well, be careful, we have the plus or minus. So in fact, we have two answers here already, the positive version and also negative version. And we have a negative inside of the square root. That will give us the imaginary unit I. Square root of 2, just leave it as how it is. There you have it. 2, negative 1 half, positive I square root of 2, and negative I square root of 2. These are the four answers to that polynomial equation. Hopefully this right here helps. That's it.